September 1915, Grace sent me an excellent present of a Bible that cost 2 and 6. Could you please send me an ounce or two of tobacco? There's none in camp. I miss my wife and children so much.
The words of Private Hugh Thomas, who left his life as a farm labourer on Anglesey to join up in early 1915. Married and with 3 children, he was a prolific letter writer. Today, his granddaughter still treasures those letters, many of which were sent from the front line. Originally written in Welsh, she's translated each one. They're read here by a serving soldier from the Welsh Regiment.
March 1916. By the time you get this letter, I will have moved into the firing line. I saw dozens of bodies lying quite peacefully over the field.
When he gets to the places, much pleasanter than he thought. But of course, after that, it goes downhill. And he does talk about the horror of the trenches.
The war did have its lighter moments, but danger was never far away for Hugh and his comrades. In July 1916, he fought at the Battle of Mametz Wood. By 1917, he was back on the front line. His letters convey a sense of resignation.
July 1917. It's my birthday today, ma'am. I would love to come home, if only to get a clean shirt. It's time for it to end. There have been enough men killed. It's cold and the nights are long.
He never talks about fear in his letters. He just talks about the pity of it all. And he's resigned. He says, well, that's how it is. But what a shame it is, and why doesn't it end?
Later that year, about to spend another Christmas in the trenches, Hugh writes another letter home.
Christmas Eve, 1917. Nano, I received a parcel and the Christmas pudding was very good. I made a little fire to fry the pudding in some fat, as Mam always did. I thought a lot about Mam as I was doing it, hoping this awful war would be over soon.
It just seems so awful, really, you know, that, you know, here he was, you know, out in France, and all he can think about, you know, is being at home. At the end of it, he says that I am writing this on Christmas Eve. You know, good night to you all, sort of, and a happy Christmas.
A little over 2 weeks later, he was killed. His body lies in a foreign field. His spirit survives through letters still read and remembered.